Hey guys, real quick before this episode starts, I'm gonna explain a couple of things in the beginning when the episode actually starts, but at this point, this is present me talking while I'm editing the problems that we had that we mentioned in the problems video, and I'm really tired right now, so sorry if it doesn't sound quite coherent. But yeah, unfortunately, I was not able to completely recreate the audio in the fights. It was impossible. Timing in other places made it a little bit difficult. I got all the cutscenes audio dialogue back, and I got some ambient dialogue back, or like some ambient like conversations going on. But a lot of you mentioned that you really just would like to watch, you know, if nothing else, that you wouldn't even mind if the video was quiet all the way through as long as there were subtitles and my commentary, and I really appreciate that. I want you to know. However, hopefully what I've been able to do is something that kind of meshes the two, the original idea and your guys' idea together into like a cohesive, well-made unit. So let me know what you think, if it's too quiet or too loud or it's too weird to like have two different types of, you know, there's like silence and then there's like audio for some parts. Let me know if that's weird. Yeah, definitely let me know what you think about this video, because I've been editing it all evening and I want to know what you guys think so I can like change it up a little bit if I need to, which I'm totally fine with. But yeah, so, oh, also the changes in the parts where it cuts into the new audio or the fixed audio is actually the game post the first patch. So the eyes look much better, faces look a little better, and inventory's been changed, and you can skip the galaxy scenes, but I don't do any of that because I was trying to recreate it. But yeah, so it's been interesting, and I'm looking forward to hearing what you guys think. Thanks. Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda, where unfortunately I have to be a little bit quiet because I'm currently in a hotel for my job. Been doing archaeology stuff, and yeah. Been doing archaeology stuff and sorry, I'm distracted. I have to be super quiet, and so the mic is not picking me up very well, I don't think, but I do have to be quiet. So hopefully I won't be screaming and yelling as much. But yes, unfortunately, I have to be quiet. Yes, for archaeology, I'm currently in Oregon, and I'm doing some survey work out here, and I brought all my video game stuff, and I am going to play Andromeda just for a little bit each day. Also, I can't tell if it's just me or the screen or what, because I'm not playing on my normal flat screen. I'm playing on a flat screen, but it looks like it's fading the graphics a little bit. I'm not sure. That's just me or not, but anyway, I'll do my best. If this recording doesn't turn out very well, I may have to hold off on playing Andromeda for a bit. But I didn't want to have to wait 10 days to not play, you know what I mean? So. So let's see where this goes. I need to sell some things. Oh god, it's so bright. Oh god. Bye. I do love this. I think it's cool. I put the microphone a little bit closer to me. It's on my cooler now. Let's see. I have to like tilt it up funny and everything, so hopefully you can still hear me, even while I have to be quiet. Okay. Oh man. So you see, we have so many things we have to do. I really want to get to the Kadara place, Because apparently there's one more romance option there named Reese. Blah. Blah. Oh, I think, oh. Okay, yeah, I have to talk to those guys. Who was it? Where's my... Okay. Yes. Did that. Oh, and I don't know if we saw this, but despite the potential Ket threat, you guided the outpost on Eos on a mission of peaceful scientific exploration of the Hyas cluster. You proved yourself an ally to the Angara by supporting their research efforts on Havarl. There was something else. Okay, that was Drac. Callow and Gil don't get along. Oh, okay. He's invited you to hang out socially. Oh, okay. Zhao. He's keeping you at arm's length for now, and it seems you'll need to gain his trust too. Okay. Rider. I don't know if we read this either, but I use warmth and humor in many situations. Your casual and open nature is welcomed by much of the team. I would note, however, that your tendency towards sarcasm has been mentioned to me by Initiative Hierarchy and Director Tan in particular. This shouldn't be seen as a problem, but rather as an indication of a unique take on survival and success. We'll see. It'd be cool. Oh. And I was honest. So it remembers that I visited my brother when he was in a coma, and I was honest with him about Dad, and I was honest with him about the struggles that we face in finding a home. So I'm hoping that being honest was a good idea. I got remnant data. That was cool. Y'all just freaking out. Yeah. Man, I love the jump jet. I really do. Nothing in this game has made me regret getting it. But now what? Is there a point of being down here? Can I get over there? Can I even do anything down here yet? Looks like I have to go up. Going down wasn't what I needed to be doing. I also just really like Ryder. I like how Ryder is very, like, with Shepard, you were a confident, you know, soldier and everything, but Ryder is funny, like, and I've seen some other, just, like, snippets of other little, like, things that Ryder will say, like, when you're, like options I didn't choose by chance, and, like, he or she is very funny, and they're just, like, kind of, like, they're just dealing with this the same as you are. You are Ryder. Even more than I think you could be Shepard. Like, Shepard was like a fantasy insert, but Ryder is like how a person would react to this sort of a thing, you know? So I really like Ryder. She holds her own to Shepard for sure. Oh, please. Okay, good. Whoa. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, what? 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 I didn't even mean to, and it wouldn't even let me jump out. I tried. Oh my gosh, are you serious? The one spot in the entire area where you could die, and I just fell into it. I feel stupid. I feel really stupid. Yeah. guess. I can't get in yet? Whoa. Oh, okay. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Now you're there. How do I play this game? They are angry. Gun. Oh, crap. 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 Oh my gosh, I got stuck. Wait, what? What? What just happened? I don't know. I've glitched my game. I can't move. I can only jump. No, I can't move. Can I die? I'm just having really bad luck. Oh, man. This goo is determined to kill me. See, I say Ryder is really understandable as a hero, and it's because she trips and falls face first into poison goo. Which is exactly what I would do. I am loving this shotgun, by the way. It's probably the best thing that's happened to me. What are you? Holy... Dodge, dodge, dodge. Favorites. Let's be an adept. You know, as much as we say, oh, because we're apparently checking out this place, this planet, for an outpost, it's supposed to be the Turians. And technically, even then, it's actually the Angaran homeworld. We can't put an outpost here without their permission. You know what I'm saying? So it seems kind of weird. Are we gonna have another fight? Are we done yet? Did we just go in a giant circle for no reason? Did I fight all those things for no reason? Am I not supposed to be here yet? Alright, well, I guess we're not supposed to be here because I don't know how to get through. What's my priority right now? Okay, let's go talk to Ephra. Jeez. I will hopefully edit a bunch of that out because since it's useless time wasting. I was going to try to make this place more habitable, but apparently I can't do that yet. I'm busy. I gotta go talk to this really attractive guy. You know, forward and main quest stuff, I guess. Also, I do need to talk to people, so... I'd rather do that than the stupid dungeons. I hope I can just land on some random planets. Maybe not, though.
Jal says Ephra is waiting for your call, Pathfinder.
Pathfinder, you have new email.
Perfect drift.
You know we've got a finite set of tires, right?
Also limbs. And lives.
Well, what's the point of having them then?
Bitcoin channels are ready, Pathfinder.
Commander?
Pathfinder. Joel's been keeping me updated on your... adventures, your good deeds on our behalf.
You're welcome.
I meant them. I want you to know you can trust me.
You went out of your way to free that science team. A selfless act. But your true agenda is clear. To explore Aya's vault. Jarl says you want to help the Moshi. Why should I let you?
I'd like this to be the beginning of a strong relationship.
Keep your promises, and little by little, our bond might grow. We've managed to trace the Moshi to a special cat facility on Vold.
Why special?
These facilities are protected by a dynamic shield tech we haven't been able to crack. We're close, but its ability to adapt outstrips the speed of our current processors.
Pathfinder, adding my processor to their program would no doubt make the difference.
Hmm.
Ephra, I can help. Respectfully, this time you need my help.
Respectfully? The Angara don't need anything from you. We take care of our own.
With the processing power of my AI, I can guarantee the shield breach.
AI? Of course, that makes sense.
He's physically connected to me, so I need to... Well, I want to go.
It was risky to be honest about your AI. And honestly,
yeah, I figured honesty about the AI would be good.
I hope so.
I hoped. Okay, good. That was a good...
Thank you.
That was a good
risk.
The team
will meet you at our base on Vold. They'll take you to the camp facility. Stay strong and clear. Goodbye.
Oh, wow. Okay, then. Friend or foe? Okay. Hey, guy. Hey, little guy. How's it going? Yeah, pretty sure. Pretty sure. My bucko. What's that? Okay. Jal wanted to say something.
So, you've gained Ephra's trust. No easy feat.
I still don't think he likes me.
That's just his way. You should be more worried about the Rokar.
Ephra made it seem like you had experience with them.
I know their leader, Aksul. We studied together under the Moshai, but unlike me, he was a good student. The best,
Joe,
actually.
What's wrong with your arms?
Then he knows about Remnant?
He did. It's a long story.
Give me the short
version.
No, I
want to hear the long one.
Aksul was captured by the Kit. He spent a year in a forced labor camp before he managed to escape.
I can't imagine what he must have gone through.
He has scars that would give you an idea. When Aksul returned, he no longer cared about the Remnant or anything except destroying the Kit.
Why not join the Resistance?
Aksul's not the type to follow orders. And I think he was bitter we weren't able to rescue him.
That's a fair point.
So he formed the Rokar.
We didn't give them much thought. But since your people arrived, his cause has grown.
Let's see.
I convinced Ephra I'm not a threat. Maybe I can do the same with Aksul.
I admire your courage. But Aksul's dangerous, and he lacks Ephra's pragmatism. He'll make you want to kill him.
I have to try.
If Helios is to be your home, I guess you'll have to deal with the Rokar one way or another. There's a recluse on Havarul who escaped with Aksul from the Kit. Her name is Tholdir. She might know how to contact him. I'll send you the nav point.
Okay. I have to read my emails to... Yeah, let's go... Just read my emails first. What? Is he playing poker with Gil and losing his credits? Sam, how's it going? Okay. Let's turn on some jams. Why don't they stay on? I poker awaits. Rider the bell tolls for thee. Meet me in the vortex on Nexus. I'll be the one shuffling the deck of doom. Okay. Asari refugees. There's a report of Asari refugees on Eos. They made it. Might know about their arc, too. Let's talk when you're free. Okay. Making contacts from Liam. Heads up. First thing I did after Aya, figure out who to really talk to. Because we all know the ones in charge, they're not on the ground. Jal had some pointers, and I got some names from smaller Angaran colonies. It'll be a while before they trust us, but it's all about exposure. Saw all the time in crisis response, especially post-combat zones. Low Consul Varand. If you see any messages from her, it's just me reaching out. What? Liam has included a list of media themed to first contact. Genres include hard science fiction and an Asari bit about first contact with humanity, titled How They Must See Us. He's really into this. Balanced diet. From Lexi. As part of overseeing the crew's physical and mental welfare, I thought I'd send along the following tips for a balanced diet. Given the large amount of exercise you partake in each day, it's important that your body receives the nutrients it needs. Thanks, Lexi. He's very impressed you're able to scientist, and I've made sure he knows you played a key role. Maybe he's already said these things to you, but if I know Ephra, he probably hasn't. As for me, I learned a lot about trust. Being on this team, letting myself be open to trusting you and the others. I've learned that trust is more of a feeling than a science. And it seems like it is a universal truth. Universal. Get it? What? I'll try to be more trustful in the future. This assignment might change my life. Good night, Jal. Okay, Jal. Let's see. Where's Drac? I was like, I can't get in? Okay, I'm just double checking.
You know, there was a time when Sid was afraid of space. We were traveling a lot, and one day she just woke up and realized there was nothing outside the shuttle walls. Happened more than once. She'd panic. I'd hold her for as long as it took. She doesn't even remember now. It was only for a month or two.
Funny, huh? The things they don't remember.
And you feel like it's up to you to hold on to it, or else it's just gone.
And there's just something there that you know you're missing.
Hmm.
Drac?
Interesting.
Just hold on to it.
Ryder.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Drac.
Dead is a nice little piece of paradise the Angara have. Wouldn't mind seeing it again.
I wouldn't mind either. Maybe we can have something like that too, someday.
We rescue that Moshi of theirs. Maybe they'll give us some tips.
We can talk
on how to
later.
Get a nice planet.
Sure.
Ooh, look at the hair. The hair moves. Word of the Angar and word of the day. Tavum, a pleasant intoxicant stirred into hot water or fruit juice. What's it made from? Is it sweet or more like beer? What happens if you mix it with booze? Does it get better? Do they cancel each other out, Drac? We need to do some scientific tests, maybe with little umbrellas. I love this crew so much. I do. I think they outdid themselves. The writers. They did outdid themselves with this crew. Oh, wow. Where is she? Is she up there? Oh, she is. I wonder if I could... Oh, I can't. I was like, I wonder if I could catch her from here. Okay. I don't mind having... I know I could look on the map for him, but I don't mind looking around. Wow. That is impressively bright. Nomad. Hope I can get some more custom paint jobs for it. It'd be fun. Oh no. No. The Mass Effect core. I like it. Looks good. I'm glad they kept the design the same. It's a recognizable piece of the past.
Aya is a wonder rider, and the Angara are so interesting. I hope we make it back. I want to delve and explore and who knows what else.
We'll be back. We need the Moshi if we're going to get into their vault.
Oh, I'm definitely sticking around long enough for that.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
Okay, what? You just did like a weird eyebrow thing. I keep wanting to jump and skip, but I don't have my biotics on. I turned my biotics off. Okay, Liam. Wait. Nope, it's not here. I don't care. Liam.
Pathfinder. Hey, I was wondering, could you put your stamp on a project? It's for me and Jarl to work on. Call it diplomacy if you have to put it in a budget bucket. Greenlight that research and it's all good.
What's your read on the people we're working with?
I'm... okay.
Crew, they're all fine.
You must have opinions.
Your opinion's more important. What do you think of your people?
The math says we have all the right qualifications. I trust that.
That's probably what the Nexus is counting on. That our skills fit together to make it work. Up to us to figure it out. That's why this is our ship. So we own it. Want to make it work.
Okay, that's kind of a weird thing to say. The math adds up.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
Okay, do I build it here or what? No, I build it here. Well, let's talk to Jaw first.
Is there something else?
A few more questions, if that's okay.
Yeah, we won't know till we try.
I want to learn more about your species.
What would you like to know?
Wow, okay, here we go.
How long have you had electromagnetic capabilities? How did they evolve?
No idea. Biology doesn't interest me, but I'm sure you can easily read up on it.
That's disappointing. No biology at all?
How do your eyeballs work?
An internal lens focuses an image onto the retina where it becomes electrical impulses that are deciphered by the brain.
You took my sarcasm as an invitation to show off. Pitiful.
The Angara seem so open and free with their feelings.
Are we? We're certainly not ashamed of our feelings. We're taught that feelings and beliefs should live on the outside, where they can be dealt with honestly and openly.
Don't people get hurt?
Of course. Then everyone deals with it. That's the point.
Oh, that... Hey, you know?
How many colonies do you have? On what planets?
Since the Scourge, we've managed to survive on a small number of planets. What we know from before the Scourge is mostly oral history. We did have spaceflight, and the stories tell of 5 original colonies.
How long has it been? Like, one person said 80 years, but he said centuries. Like,
is there a central Angaran religion?
There are many variations. An almanac could give you an accurate number. But if you are a believer, the essential tenet is, after we die, we are reincarnated. We evolve to make our families strong. Born from what was before. Blessed to be better than before.
Are you a believer?
No. Yes. Sometimes. I don't know if it's the same for humans. Sahuna, my true mother, is a firm believer.
What's a true mother?
You studied with Moshi Sefa. Is she a teacher or a religious figure?
She's many things. She's a clear thinker with deep knowledge and insight. She teaches and inspires. She is beloved. I love her.
Really? So one of those professor-student things?
No, not that way. Moshe Sefer is 115 of your years old.
So?
Well, enough about okay. that.
I knew what he meant, but I just hate being so... I'm trying to draw a fine line between, like, her falling back on being, like, a professional and, like in certain situations, like, having sort of a, like, you know, oh, like, let's be strong allies or whatever, you know, but she's also very passionate and she loves, like, the logical sciences and stuff like that, but... So I'm still kind of trying to figure out how she would react to all these situations.
Can you tell me more about the Ket occupation?
It's a difficult subject. I'll answer what I can. I may get emotional.
Okay.
When the Ket came, why didn't you fight?
They didn't give us a reason to. Until they did. Then it was too late. Perhaps you think we were weak. But the Ket are ruthless. They are masters at knowing exactly when and how to strike.
I get that, believe me. Have the Ket always been here?
No. Some, like the Moshai, are old enough to remember.
What's with this mother's thing?
But I don't. Nor do my mother's.
And the Archon came with them?
We think so. Resistance intel on that is unclear, and few have seen him in person.
And live to tell?
And live to tell.
So, like, is this, like, a society where, like, I don't know, like, you're born to one mom and then, like, other moms help raise you, you know? Like, there's no aunts, maybe, just, like, mom figures, maybe?
What's living under the Ket been like for you?
Do you really want to hear about these things? They're painful.
I asked, didn't I?
It's like living on unstable ground. Every day brings more horrible news. I part company with someone not knowing if I'll ever see them again. When I was a boy, my father vanished from my life. One horrible day.
Was he in the resistance?
No. He was a technician at a mine. He went to work and didn't come home. That happens for an Angara child somewhere, every single day.
Jeez.
Well, enough about that.
Yikes. This is so awkward.
Stay strong and clear.
Thank you. Some of the things that Ryder says are kind of awkward. Just in context.
Yes?
Okay, bye.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
I need to find Cora. Was the research... What was it that they wanted to do? Oh. Sure. It's a pet project. Diplomatic effort. Okay, Liam. Where'd you go, buddy? I did what you asked. Okay. We'll get to him before we go. Oh, there's Gil. He's still up here. What you doing, Gil?
Hey, Ryder. What's the story?
Good talking to you, Gil.
Bye.
Anytime.
Bye. Cora.
Did you hear the news from EOS? Asari refugees showed up at the outpost. Only a few, but that's better than none. Bradley says there's an officer in charge, Hidaria. She could know where the Ark is.
We'll head to Eos and see what she knows.
Good. Rumor says Sarissa Theris was on the Asari Ark. Exactly who we need.
Who's she?
Probably the best commando strategist alive. Her biotic shields saved hundreds at the Battle of Kirkus. Apparently, Sarissa's acting as bodyguard to the Asari Pathfinder. She's probably got a plan out of this mess already.
Well, someone's a fan.
No, I'm a fan. I just like... Look, we need someone with her experience. That's all.
I'll take someone with that much experience. Another reason to find the Ark.
When you're ready to look, we can catch Hidari at Prodromos.
I think she'd just come.
Wouldn't mind tagging along.
Okay. Let's see. Ooh, we talked to Korra. Let's see what these two are up to.
The discovery of Aya was just what we needed, Ryder. The Ngaran scientists have been so generous in sharing their wisdom. It's been amazing.
Ngaran expertise will be a tremendous help to the initiative.
We were certainly hurting for it. I'm thankful the Angara were willing to risk working with us.
I'm afraid not all of them are quite so friendly.
Some give trust easily. From others, you have to earn it. I'm confident we'll get there.
I let go!
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
I'm socially inept, and I don't know what to do.
That leg of my workbench needed propping up.
If you bothered reading it, you'd know that the Tempest is an orchestra of new tech. You can't just meddle with...
I got this ship launch-ready in record time, Callow. I know my stuff.
And you don't have a shred of respect for other people's...
Callow.
Oh, Ryder. Sorry you had to hear that. What can I do for you?
You and Gil still aren't getting along?
He's being stubborn. All I want is for him to respect the ship. Apparently, that's too much to ask.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Really, really stupid that I can't address a conflict between my pilot and my engineer. Okay. I need to go play with Gil. Right. Take Korra to go to Eos. I also need to get, I need to download movies from the Nexus or something. Let's go talk to Liam really quick. Where you at, buddy? Callow. Korra. Jaw. Gil. Lexi. PB. Petra. Sam. Liam. So he's back in the storage room? Okay. And down we go. Is it here? No. That's my room. Right. My room. You just lurking.
Liam, I signed off on that project.
Hello.
That's great, Pathfinder. Jarl Amaldarov, we got our gear.
Oh my Costa, gosh.
Ryder.
What?
Is this show for my benefit? Because I'm benefiting.
Just convenience. Swapping armor. Ready to go?
Go.
Why?
Right.
Jarl just walked in here family with that top. That means he's been walking through the ship without a top on.
No.
Why? Is it religious?
Wait, what?
You're not allowed. Because of status or species?
Maybe it's both.
Do all humans look alike?
Some of you sound alike.
Whoa.
Nice. Interesting. Well, I'm curious.
I thought this was about armor. Are you deliberately trying to offend Jal?
No.
Of course he is.
That's the point. Asking stuff diplomats leave out. Armor for answers.
My turn was earlier. Nexus info packets leave a lot out.
What?
I am sorry. Was this not sanctioned?
Oh, you weaseling Adi.
Nevertheless.
Oh my gosh, he's butt naked. He's butt naked. Why is he butt naked?
You better have a good reason for this.
I do. And we were clear. Jaw was in from the start.
Did I say put
You're
the
not
shit
naked.
Oh, we were shit talking. Except we couldn't. We didn't know enough about each other to dig in. If we don't know what's insulting or awful, we might accidentally trip on it. Makes talking dangerous. For now we know. And maybe that's enough for a couple of hotheads not to make a mess out there. Unless we want to. Good enough reason?
Okay, I kind of get the intent. No harm, no foul.
If Jar was offended, I'd be on the floor. I'll take that kind of honest any day. We have a lot to learn. That's part of what
they're
our team
both is very honest people.
Better now than when people's lives are on the line.
I like that. That was a good idea. I don't know. I came. Okay, we can talk with your shirt off. Okay.
Pathfinder.
Hi.
Sorry, distracted. Feels like things should be on hold until the Moshi business is squared away. It's the neighborly thing to do. And we need good neighbors.
Yeah, bye. I'll okay, bye.
I know it.
Why? He still doesn't have a shirt on. I love it. No, I need to stop trying to do the logical answer ones. Because those ones don't usually turn into what I want them to be. But I think that was a really good idea. I mean, he was literally asking really good questions. I thought they were really good questions that he was asking. Like, important things that we need to know. Like, but they're important things to know between species, you know? Like, he was asking anthropological questions, like, things that may seem kind of pushy, but that just help you to inform you on the species, you know? Like, he couldn't, like, apparently Liam can't wear the poncho thing. It's a social status species thing. Who knows? These are important and interesting questions. I thoroughly approve of that. I didn't think they were bad talking each other at all. They were just getting to know each other. Man, I don't think there was much change you could have done in that situation though. Cause it was like, you know, this isn't okay, or explain what's going on. Whoa. Shielding a city district. Wow. That sounds really cool. Thanks, Cora. I appreciate it. Okay, apparently we need to go meet the resistance on Bold now. I can't really think of anything else I want to be doing right now. I mean, we could go play on the Nexus, but I feel like this is sort of pressing, you know? Oops. Oof. Okay, system. And then further out. Trail of Hope. I love the galaxy. This is beautiful. I love the travel.
So
gosh dang beautiful.
Deploying pro. tracking a huge mineral deposit.
I hope nobody minds that we're just taking their stuff. There's always something in the asteroid belts. Wow. This one only has a designation, not an actual name. We want to go see the sun.
Anomaly on sensors.
Yeah, right there. Yeah.
Probes launched. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Oh, this empty Angaran escape pod appears to have been drifting over past 55 for nearly a decade. Markings suggest it came from an exploratory vessel. Its data is now yours to carry forward. Okay. Oh, geez. Lots of stuff. Oh, maybe I should go to my, really quick, I should go to my little cell area. I have my little computer terminal that I can sell things on. Look at all these nebula. They're awesome. I am just beyond impressed with what they've done with the environments. It's largely covered in oceans of nitrogen churned by powerful winds. The storms make detailed surface scans difficult. Okay. Sounds cool though. Oceans of nitrogen. Jeez. Right there? In the eye of the storm?
Probe away. I found something.
Massive hurricane is carrying a sort of nitrogen adapted plankton over the ocean. It seems to be home to simple life forms. Oh, cool. I'm level 10. How exciting. What all did I get? Okay, before... Oh yeah, look at that, look at that. This is one of my favorite things. Let's go look at for my room. And then I will also go sell things. But I want to look at the planet from my room. Man, my windows are like weird looking, you know? Planetary hollow. Do I have a nexus point? I was wondering if there was actually something I could... Okay. We'll be sure to come back and keep asking him for jokes. What am I doing? I'm going to sell things. I don't know why she's out here all the time. Yes. What about, like, I think is salvage... Yeah, it looks like you can just sell all salvage for money. Whoa. No, I wish to go through with it. Yes. Wow, I have a lot of money now. Jeez. Okay. Not that I know what to do with any of it, but it's out of my inventory space now. Look at that. Look at that. Look at all that inventory space.